Hey everybody, Rich here. Nope, not a guitar video, keyboard video. Philips SBK8401B, cheap mechanical keyboard. It is a blue switch. It is a true mechanical. Let's get this stupid key back on here. And what I'm gonna do, and this is the itty bitty manual that it came with, excuse me. So, and I'm gonna do this video on how to use this keyboard. It's like, well, what do you mean? Yeah, it's not exactly straightforward. It works. Full anti-ghosting, key rollover, all that stuff. Let's get something out of the way first. Typing action. For a blue key switch. Good. And let me just turn off this light here. That's better. Now we can see it better. How do you turn the lights off? FN, and then if you notice, increase brightness, decrease brightness, and this will increase or decrease the breathing thing, because this thing has a bunch of lighting effects in it, but FN, and then down until it's out. And then you have three levels of brightness, low, medium, high. Set it back to low. If we are, I'll just quickly go through the lighting effects, which you use with function and the insert key. This is the first one here, which is afterglow. Next one, breathing. And this is where I can show the speed keys here if I increase. Now it breathes faster, breathes slower. I'll just keep it on fast. Next mode, WASD and escape and arrow keys are lit up. Next one, and yes, there is key lockout on this. I'll get to that in a minute. Next one is this pattern. You can adjust the speed if you want, again with the breathable left and right if you want to. Next one is this pattern. Next one is this pattern. It does a roundabout and then it does this. Next one is a breathable, but this time it goes from left to right. This one is the most annoying one. Yes, it is as annoying as it looks. And yes, the color is only white. And then we go back to this. Now, according to the manual here, you have... Now, that's not the end of it, because there's more to this. You have gaming modes. Now, you have some preset ones from 1 through 8, and then two custom modes. So if I do, this two-handed, FN1, you get WASD, and that, if you get F2, function 2, you get all these. You notice that not all, this is for specific gaming types, and then function 3 is this set. See if I can do this one-handed. Function 4. Is this function 5, function 6, function 7, function 8. Now, when it comes to function 9 and 0, okay, if I do a function 9, everything's blank because we haven't set it yet. So we record the keys we want to have active in this mode. So I do that by starting record by function home. And let's just say I want just those keys active and just that. Okay, I'm done. So now I save with a function end. Okay, now if I'm at, it's like this. If I want to retrieve that setting, function 9. And there are the keys I just had. Now there's a second one. If I go function 0 and then function home to record this one, okay, just that, and then function end to save. Okay, so if I go back to my first custom setting 9, it's that one like before, and then function 0, it's this one. And that's the way that works. Now if I want to get out of this, I can do function insert, and then just hit it a few times, and back to normal mode here. You can lock out the window. Let me bring back the manual here. You can switch between WASD and direction keys. You have 8 gaming modes, 2 custom patterns. These up here. So, come on, focus, will you? Oh my God, why you want? Okay. So you have these up here, which means player volume decrease, increase, mute, stop, previous, play pause, move next, email, home, lockout. What is that? A keypad lockout, a calculator. And that these, if you don't know what these mean, this means print screen, scroll lock, pause break. Now the scroll lock is actually kind of interesting because if you do, it says switch between gaming mode and full key anti-rollover. So that's if you do a function scroll lock. And I think that's about it with this keyboard. I'm pretty sure. It's pretty loaded for what it is, and it's relatively inexpensive. I bought it just, I wanted a nice keyboard to type on that didn't annoy me. And this fits the bill. Again, this is Philips SPK8401B, as in Bravo. It's got a bunch of lighting effects in it. I like the fact, again, it's just white. Oh, last thing I'll say up here, I like that those little blue lights, they're not... My God, my phone will not focus on... Okay. They're bright, but not piercing bright. I like that. Also, in addition to that, this is the lowest setting for the lighting, but the camera makes it look a lot brighter than it actually is. The full bright setting, you can really see this, but when it's in this mode, it looks basically just like a regular keyboard. Does the job. I like it. It's true mechanical. Key travel is good. It's cheap. I so apologize that my phone is having such a hard... You know why it's having a hard time focusing on this? Because of the lighting stuff. Actually, if I turn the lights out... Yeah, now it's having a much easier time. But that's no fun to look at it like that. So, and again, function insert goes through all the lighting modes. And this little manual that it comes with, be sure to save this because you're going to need to reference this if you want to remember how to program in your custom modes and how to lock out certain keys so you don't accidentally press them if you use it for gaming. I don't game, but if you do, that stuff is important to you. So anyway, that's it. Cool keyboard.